Hello everyone, welcome back to Forensic Solutions. So, as we discussed about web APIs in our last video, so today we are going to talk about common attacks against web APIs. The first is injection. One common type of attack against API is injection. Injection attack is a malicious code injected in a network which fetches all the information from the database and sends it to the attacker. It is the oldest and most dangerous attack aimed at web application. This can include compromising both backend system as well as client connected to the vulnerable application. Type of injection attacks: SQL injection, HTML injection, code injection, command injections, and content injections. The second is cross-site scripting or XSS. This attack is a type of injection attack, and its common attack vector that injects malicious code into a vulnerable web application. A successful cross-site scripting attack can have devastating consequences for an online business reputation and its relationship with its clients. Cross-site scripting attacks occur when data enters a web application through an untrusted source, or most frequently a web request. The data is included in dynamic content that is sent to a web user without being validated or malicious content, and that's how data is extracted. The third is distributed denial of services, also known as DDoS attack. DDoS attacks can be devastating as they cripple your application, system, or even whole network. A DDoS attack involves multiple connected online devices, collectively known as a botnet, which are used to overwhelm a target website with fake traffic. DDoS attacks can come in short bursts or repeat assaults, but either way, the impact on a website or a business can last for days, weeks, and even months as the organization tries to recover. This can make DDoS extremely destructive to any online organization. Fourth is lack of resource and rate limiting. This draws into our previous example that can be made even worse by not implementing proper rate limiting. This would allow the attacker to cripple our system even faster than before by requesting unreasonable amount of data in a very short time frame. So, an API client can make thousands or even more API calls per second, or request 100 or thousands of data records at once, and the server will still try to fulfill these requests. The fifth is improper assets management. This vulnerability is more of a human or management problem that allows older APIs to remain in place long after they should have been replaced by newer or more secure version. Attackers find non-production versions of API, for example, stagging, testing, beta, or earlier versions that are not as well as protected as the production API, and use those to launch their attacks. These APIs can cause great damage as they are not actively maintained and often overlooked when creating new features, which could lead to unauthorized access of data. So, this was all about for today's video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, stay secure.